The Columbian Exchange, a la Shmoop.
You sorry about that?
It was the biggest trade of the millennium. The Columbian Exchange.
Oh, excuse me.
The Columbian Exchange refers to the exchange of cultures, resources, languages, and ideas following Columbus' voyage to the Americas in 1492.
Despedida!
Unfortunately, diseases were also exchanged.
Yeah, you might want to get tested.
And the native peoples of the Americas were killed en masse and had their resources raided by Europeans.
Are you sorry about that?
Ever since the Columbian Exchange, the world has grown smaller as it becomes easier and easier to interact with different cultures. Today, with fast modes of transportation, the internet, and other modern technology, we really do have the whole world in our hands. If you could do your own Columbian Exchange with any culture, which culture would you choose?
Is Beverly Hills culture an option?
Think of it as your personal exchange. If your name is George, for example, you could call it the Georgian Exchange.
I like the sound of that.
Do you want to exchange knowledge, resources, and ideas with a culture you already know?
I've always been interested in ancient Rome.
Or maybe something or somewhere you don't know much about at all, so you could learn things that are completely new to you.
What do you call that continent again? You know, the big one.
Let's take France, for example. You might learn the secrets for cooking what many people consider to be the world's greatest cuisine, including snails.
What did I ever do to you?
Sometimes exchanges can have unwanted side effects, though. Remember the smallpox thing with the Columbian Exchange?
Oh, no.
We wonder what the problems with a French exchange would look like. Please don't poison our wine.
Fruity and robust, with a hint of arsenic.
So who would you make your exchange with, and why?
I just couldn't make up my mind.
What would you expect that each side would gain from it? Shmoop amongst yourselves and let us know. We'll post your ideas.